Hello friends, welcome to Abhyas Training Institute, and in this video we will be talking about how we can use MATLAB in mobile phone. So MATLAB provide us an application, so we can install that application in our mobile and we can use MATLAB in mobile phone. So we can use the sensors of our mobile phone with MATLAB application. So in this video we will see how we can install MATLAB mobile in our mobile phone. So to download the application, what you need to do, you need to open your Play Store. Any Play Store, you can search for MATLAB. Okay, so you can search for MATLAB, and when you search for MATLAB, you can see the icon has appeared here and you can click on install. Now you can see MATLAB mobile has been downloaded and it is installing in our mobile phone. So when installation is complete, we can open. Okay, so now you can see that open icon has appeared, so we can click on that open icon. So here you can see some information like MATLAB mobile connect to MATLAB session running on MathWorks clouds. So what this app does, it's connect us to MATLAB cloud, so we can save our files, our program on MATLAB cloud directly, and we can use. Okay, so we can use sensors information and all the stuff. We can write up code in our mobile phone. So let's continue. So when you click on continue, you can see it, that application required MathWorks account. If you don't have an account, you can create from here. So whenever you can click on create one and you can create an account. So I already have account in MathWorks, so I will use my personal email address to connect with MATLAB cloud. So now it's asking for password, so we can enter our password and we can click on sign in. Okay, so now we have to accept that agreement. We don't have any choice. Okay, so now you can see we are connecting to MathWorks cloud. Now you can see we are getting one notification: upgrade MATLAB mobile to unlock more features like acquiring data from device sensor and 5GB of cloud storage. So to upgrade MATLAB mobile, we need to have a MATLAB account, but right now I am not going to upgrade. I will continue with trial account only. So here you can see this is our command window. You can verify how I can say it is command window. You can type one command like date, and so you can see we have got an answer like 6 July 2020. Okay, so this is our command window. So here we have got some more options, like here you can see we will get date print, means here we will get a history, so what command we have used here, and here we can see if we have plotted any data or like. So I have previously plotted one data, so you can see here we can see the data, and we can save this picture to our device or we can share it. And then what we have, and then here you can see we have files, commands, sensor, examples. So files, so whenever you click on files, you can see I have one is published and one is my personal file like first. So this is my .m file that I have created. I have created that m file, and if you want to create a new m file, you can click on that plus sign. Okay, so here you can get options like new file, new folder, take photo, record video, upload photos. So this is the option available here, and you can click on new files, and in new file you can give a name like training. Okay, and we can create one m file here, and here we can write our program. So I will start like clc. okay, clc, then I will like clear all, you should know about all this file, okay, all this command, sorry. And here we can data. Okay, so we can create one data here. Okay, so we have type a data, then we can plot it. I will change that name to data, then I will use that data here, and we can run that file from there. So you can see that we have got our data and one figure. So we can open this figure. Yes, so this is our figure, and that figure belong to training. Here you can see like training. Okay, so if you want to show the data cursor, you can click here and you can check our data, and it will give you the data points like this. Okay, and here we can, again we have some options like share and save to picture. We can save this picture and it will ask for permission, so you can allow permission. There is no problem in that. Okay, and then we can close a figure, so there is no figure. Then we can again go to our files, and again we can open up our training folder and we can run. So here you can see we have got our figure again. So this is how it works. And next thing here is like sensor and example. So in example you can find the example related to our MATLAB mobile. Here one first example is like in training command that we have covered already, the means, and 2D plots. So we have covered this four topic already. So next, what I will like to show you next thing is here is like sensors. Here you can see we can use our device sensors with MATLAB mobiles. To use this feature, we need to have a upgraded, means we you need to have a MATLAB license version. Okay, so here we can get the acceleration, we can get, but right now we cannot use, means we cannot acquire that data. If you want to acquire that data, you need to have a MathWorks upgraded account. So here you can see we have a acceleration data. Okay, then we have a magnetic field, then we have a orientation like your mobile orientation. Okay, how it is oriented. Then we have angular velocity like, but you can see gyroscope, it is related to gyroscope. Then we got our GPS, and we need to give a permission. So we have enabled our location, then we can turn on that position. So you can get your location, what is your location now. Okay, so this is how it works. If you want to stream your data, then you need to have license version of MATLAB. So that's why that start button is not occurring. Then if you have that upgraded version, then you can acquire that data and you can do whatever you want. And here you can change the sampling rate also, then sensor logs. Okay, and acquire data in background, you have got a many options here. So you can select a folder where the data is acquiring. Okay, so this is how that MATLAB mobile works. So I think for this video that is enough. And if you want to go through the setting, you can see all the options available here like MATLAB keyboard. So enable MATLAB keyboard. So you need to give a permission again. And this is the MATLAB keyboard. Okay, then MATLAB keyboard is enabled. So select MATLAB keyboard. Okay, we can select a MATLAB keyboard. Then we can go to our command window, and here you can see our MATLAB keyboard has appeared. So this is very helpful. Why it is helpful? You can see all that option is available here. Previously we have to struggle like finding a square bracket or curly bracket in comma. So here you can get all the options on your main keyboard. So that's why that keyboard is fantastic when you are using a MATLAB mobile. So I think you might have got enough information how you can install a MATLAB mobile and how you can use. So in next video we will see some example in MATLAB mobile. So this is enough for this video. Thank you friend, thank you for watching this video.